I would say that environment has, since day one, been an important part of everything we do within Volvo, meaning that it is a part of thinking when it comes to production. It is a part of thinking when it comes to developing new trucks. But I would say that just to prove how important this is, we were very early out, already back in 1972, stating that we see that we need to be a part of the solution. But if we look at the problems that we're facing today, they are really global problems. Like climate change is a global challenge that we need to address all over the world in our daily work. It also is about the whole value chain, meaning that here we need to work together with our suppliers, we need to work together with our customers in order to address this together. And actually, we were very early out in putting requirements on our suppliers, environmental requirements. That was already back in the 90s. Our suppliers are also our partners. They will help us to solve many of the issues that we are facing today. As well as, I would say, that our customers are also part of this, that we need to make this journey together. We share the challenge. We have set very much the same objectives. And together, we are now testing a new technology and we are moving forward together.
Okay, so can you tell me a bit about Towards Zero at Volvo Trucks? What does it mean and is it even possible?
Our vision towards zero emissions is an important vision because it's quite clear that the climate challenge is the biggest challenge that we have as a company. And there's no question that considering everything that already has taken place, that we need to take a big, big step going forward. So Towards Zero Emissions means that we need to look at the truck during the usage, make sure that there is no added CO2. Nothing added to the atmosphere when it comes to climate gases that will have an impact on the climate. But at the same time, we also need to look at how the truck has been produced, making sure that in the production, in the material usage, that we also move towards zero emissions. Our strategy is to work in two key areas. To start with, we need to look at energy efficiency. It has always been important to us to reduce the fuel consumption. We need to improve the energy efficiency of the truck. The traditional way of doing it is, of course, to continue to improve aerodynamics. That will be very important going forward. We need to improve the rolling resistance. So even if today's tires are much better in terms of rolling resistance, they will improve over time. And of course, we need to make sure that they are used in the most optimal way. We will also continue to improve the driveline. We also need to make sure that we use the truck in an efficient way. Driver training, driver support will also be important in the future. So energy efficiency is one key part of our strategy. The other part is alternative fuels. So we need to replace the energy that's today coming to a very large extent from fossil sources. And we need to replace that with energy from renewable sources. It can be electricity coming from sun. It could be hydrogen produced with water power. It could be many different things. But the important part is to replace fossil and use energy from renewable sources. So these two paths here, energy efficiency and alternative fuels from renewable sources, are key in order to reach the Vision Zero.
Obviously at Volvo Trucks, you have a full battery electric truck range. What about other technologies, fuel cell electric and biofuels? How do you see these technologies complementing each other?
We know that there will not be one technology that can solve everything. So therefore, we are moving from a situation where we've been focusing all our energy in developing and improving the combustion engine, the diesel engine. We will continue to do the work in improving the combustion engine because we think that will be important. Because there will be areas where the electric trucks will not be the optimal solution, where we will need the combustion engine. But the two major parts that are now growing, I would say, is to start with the battery electric, where we today have a full range, which will improve over time. And in addition to that, we will also introduce fuel cell electric trucks in the future. These three different technologies will, as I said, complement each other, where we see that the battery electric trucks, just like we have introduced them, will initially be used for local and regional transports. Fuel cell electric trucks that will come in later this decade will then be used more for the longer and heavier transports. And then on top of that, we will have the internal combustion engine using, for example, biogas. So we will need all these three different technologies. And we need to develop the technologies, but of course we also need to make sure that we have all the pieces in place in order to take advantage of the technologies, to have the charging infrastructure, to have the energy in place to use these trucks in the most optimal way.
How is that improving? Do we have to take a holistic approach and all industry players need to be involved during this period of transformation?
We see that in order to solve the chicken and egg problem, meaning that we will have the electric truck, but it's not possible to use the electric truck if you don't have the charging infrastructure. We need to partner up with energy companies. It's also so that in order to make this happen in an even smoother and faster way, we have actually formed a new Volvo company called Volvo Energy, which will help us selling electric trucks by supporting the work to develop and make sure that the infrastructure is in place. So this is very much about working together, Volvo Trucks and Volvo Energy, but also working together with energy companies externally to make sure that we get this charging infrastructure in place. And the big thing here to remember is that we are not talking about slow development. We want to have a very fast development. We want to reach 50% of our sales 2030 to be electric trucks, meaning that the charging infrastructure needs to grow quite rapidly, as well as the power grids that will need to support the infrastructure here.
Let's look at the impact of batteries in electric trucks. There are lots of myths in this area. Can you clarify the climate impact of batteries?
It's always so with new technology, there are a lot of questions being raised about it. And it's definitely so that when we look at the climate impact from the production of the electric truck, it's actually twice as high as a normal diesel truck. A major part of that increase is coming from the batteries, because especially cell production for the batteries, is very energy intensive. And we see that the way to approach that is really to use our normal climate strategy, that we need to improve the energy efficiency in the production of the batteries, using less energy in the production. But we also need to look at using energy, specifically electricity from renewable sources. So those two areas will really be the key in reducing the climate impact from the batteries, and also, of course, reducing the climate impact from the whole electric truck. But also when it comes to batteries, there are many other questions. And one common question is, of course, do we know where the materials are coming from? And we are working very hard together with our suppliers to get the traceability. But we also need to make sure that we use these resources in the most efficient way. It is so that when a battery has come to the end of its life in the truck, it has still about 80% of its capacity left, meaning that it's still valuable. So we can use it in different ways. One way is to do what we call remanufacturing, that we take the batteries back, we do modifications, and then we end up with a battery that is good as new, that can be used in a truck again. Another good solution could be to give the battery a second life. One way of giving the battery a second life could be as energy storage, where we can store electricity in battery. It is, of course, important as a part of a circular thinking that we take the batteries back, that we recycle the material, and we use the material again in new batteries.
And I guess a big part of this is collaboration and partnerships with public sector and so on. How does Volvo Trucks approach that?
Today we speak a lot about partnership is the new leadership, and there's no question that that will be crucial in our success going forward. But at the same time, I would say, as a Swedish company, to work in collaboration is not something new. We speak quite a lot about what's sometimes called the triple helix. That means that we as an industry work together with the academia, work together with the public sector, because we see that we all three need to work together in order to address these common problems that we have, use the different tools that each stakeholder have access to, and together solve the issues. So that has been a success factor in many cases, and we believe that will be also a success factor when it comes to climate.
I sense your optimism. So how do you see the future when it comes to sustainable transport solutions?
I'm very optimistic that we will solve this. There's no question to me about that. And I will say that we as a company, we are also very optimistic. We are not alone in this. We see that there are customers, there are transport buyers that have set just as challenging objectives that we have had set, that are also sharing our view that we need to act and we need to do this together. At the same time as we have many stakeholders in the public sector, the decision makers, that are also saying that we need to act now. So with all this in place, all of us moving together, I think there is a good reason to be an optimist that we can solve this big challenge.
So finally, what would you say to people who are resistant to change? How do we convince them that towards zero is the way forward?
I think to start with, it's important to recognize that we don't have the time to wait. Then the second part, I would say that the technology is there. We have a whole range of battery electric trucks available already today. We have combustion engines, diesel engines, gas engines that can run on different types of biofuels. So the technical solutions are there. And on top of that, we also have energy from renewable sources available, infrastructure being built. So a lot of the different puzzle pieces are being put in place. So there is no reason to wait, because the solutions are there and the time to act is now.